It seems as if oils have become an integral part of our diet. It's on the ingredient list of many products in our grocery stores, it's in large percentage of the recipes you find online or in recipe books, and it comes with almost every dish in restaurants. There's no doubt that oils contribute to the flavor and texture of our food. While most people know it's not the best to consume oils in large amounts, they never stop the question whether we are even designed to consume oils or how it affects our health and pretty much every system in our body. So today we're going to talk about that and cover some of the unfavorable health effects that are caused by oils. Let's begin with rancid fat. What foods can become rancid? So any food that contains fat is at risk of becoming rancid, but the most problematic foods are any type of cooking oils, and unsaturated oils are even more unstable because of their chemical structure. Now, what's the problem with rancid fat? So eating rancid fat may not make you sick in the short term, but consuming rancid fat over time, over and over again, can negatively affect your health. And here's how. So fats can become rancid through the exposure to heat, light, irradiation, and oxidation. The moment fats are exposed to air, they begin the process of oxidation. And oxidation results in free radical production in the body. Now, free radicals create damage in our cells and our DNA. There are lots of issues that arise because of this process, but to name a few, the first one is that when a cell's DNA changes, the cell becomes mutated, which can increase the risk to develop cancer and other inflammatory diseases. Also, with unsaturated oils, including olive oil, heating it to high temperatures will cause the oil to develop compounds that have been found to have carcinogenic properties. Another effect that this process has is that it speeds up the aging process. The oxidation process leads to cell damage, including skin cells, and that translates into moles and age spots showing up on our skin and even wrinkles. And the last issue, which I felt is important to mention, is the damage to our brain cells. Studies on animals showed that when they were fed with oxidized vegetable oils, it showed they can cause damage to brain cells and lead to inflammation and other brain-related diseases. Although we can reduce the amount of free radicals in the body by consuming lots of fruits and vegetables that contain antioxidants, it is always better to just eliminate the root cause in the first place. Next up, our cardiovascular system. So the cardiovascular system refers to the heart, blood vessels, and the blood itself. Now, what happens when we consume oil? So within hours of ingesting oils, the blood becomes thick, which slows the flow of blood, and the arteries stiffen, which impair the ability to widen and constrict. And here's a great video that shows this very well.
This video is from Dr. Roy Swank of Oregon State University. This is the intestine of a rabbit under a microscope before and after a bolus of oil was placed into its mouth. You can see that the blood is flowing smoothly, consistently, a good flow. Now, within minutes, the blood turns into sludge, like 20-50 oil on a cold day. You can see the blood flow even stopped in the capillaries and the tissue turned blue, indicating hypoxia, thus showing how significantly oil reduces blood flow in the intestine after just one dose. The blood takes 10 hours to resume normal blood flow. We may not quite understand the mechanism, but the result is that oil and fat consumption appears quite obvious from this microscopic video film.
Hardening of the arteries occurs when fats build up in the walls of the arteries. Over time, these plaques can narrow or completely block the arteries and cause a lot of issues in the body because of the restricted flow of blood, oxygen, and nutrients that are supposed to move through the vessels. In our blood vessels, we have something called endothelial cells. These cells cover the inner lining of the blood vessels. One of their functions is to ensure proper blood flow to and from the heart, and they basically maintain the proper dilation and constriction of the blood vessels. And studies found a significant decrease in endothelial function that appears within 3 hours after a meal that contained oil, no matter the type of oil that was consumed. All kinds of oils, including olive oil, were found to contribute to the damage of the arteries and the progression of heart disease. Next is our digestive system. Oil tends to interfere with digestion, especially when consumed with carb or protein-rich foods. Unlike natural fats that we're designed to eat in nature, what happens is that oils block the digestive enzymes and inhibit proper digestion in the stomach. They also slow down the digestion process, and as a result, food spends more time in your stomach, which can cause bloating, diarrhea, stomach pain, and more. You're very likely to feel sleepy and heavy after a meal because your body has to work harder to digest and eliminate the food that just got in. And last but not least, let's talk about the nutritional value of oil. So oil is stripped away from almost all of the vitamins and minerals, leaving us with 100% fat. There are no nutritional benefits in oils. Unlike the package of nutrients that come with other healthy fats, like nuts, seeds, and avocados, for example. Oils are empty calories, and it is very easy to go over your daily calorie intake with them, since it's the most calorie-dense food available to us. In just one tablespoon of oil, you can get around 120 calories. So if you take a baked potato, for example, it has around 160 calories with close to 0% fat, while the same amount of French fries, which are fried in oil, has around 500 calories and between 30 to 45% fat. Frying with oil has over 3 times the amount of calories. Just by getting rid of the oils in your diet, you're already likely to lose weight. Of course, it depends on other things in your diet as well, but I personally know people who took just this step, just took out the oils from their diet, and they lost 5 to 10 pounds of their weight without much effort. For most people, it might not necessarily be a life or death situation, but I thought it was worth mentioning because visceral fat can be the beginning of many health problems. And for those of you who are interested in losing the last few stubborn pounds, I thought it was a great start. And now for the common question, is it okay to eat oils in small amounts? So usually the answer to this type of question is that if you eat things in moderation and stick to mostly good foods in your diet, then everything should be fine. But this is not so true in the case of oil. It all depends on how healthy you want to be and how you want your body to function. In the case of oil, even the consumption of small amounts accumulates and build up in our body, and over time damages our cells and many systems inside the moment it enters. There's really no reason to consume oils because we can get all the essential fatty acids and more nutrients from other whole and fresh fat sources. By the way, for those of you who want to dive even deeper, I'll put some links with more info in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with someone you care about. I'll see you in the next video. Although we can reduce the amount of free radicals in the body by consuming lots of vegetables.